Hello everybody, welcome to the College Dunya portal and another episode of Thoughts on Education. Today we have with us Dr. Sandeep Basant, the Registrar of Navrachna University, Vadodara. Welcome to the College Dunya portal, sir.
Thank you, Ham, and it is a pleasure being on this platform and interacting with you.
The pleasure is ours, sir. So, sir, I would just like to request you to give a brief introduction about yourself to our audience.
Yeah, so as you mentioned that I'm currently working as Registrar Navrachna University, but prior to become Registrar, I have been into academics since 15 years. I have taught to the students and, I've done my PhD in computer science. Since last 4 to 5 years, I am into the academic administration. And prior joining Navrachna University, I was associated with Ahmedabad University, Ahmedabad, for 12 years. Last 1.5 years, I have spent to, Anant National University, which is a design-focused university. It is also a very good university and emerging in the field of design and architecture. Thank you.
That's quite an impressive profile, sir. So, getting right away with the interview, my first question to you would be that, as you mentioned, you have held several key positions at educational institutes throughout your professional career. So, what are those key factors that keep you connected with the education sector?
Yeah, so let me just give you a brief that, I born in a family where my mother, sister, aunt, my uncles, they were all professors. My mother is a school principal, retired school principal. And I too was passionate about our education field since the beginning, because the environment was like that in the house itself. As you asked me about the factors that keep me inspiring to be in education field is, of course, as I said, that I'm passionate about it. Youth, is always inspiring you to do something more, to do innovative likewise. So this is one of the other factors that, youth inspires you. Then learning every day, that is a challenge in education environment because it is also a dynamic field. And above all, I consider this as a service to the society, which everyone has to give it back. And my personal belief is that real education is not only to earn a degree, but to become a responsible citizen. So these are all factors which have always, inspired me to be in the education sector. I did my first job in L&T in Mumbai as software engineer, but very quickly I found out that, I would like to do something in education, and I gave up that job, but I'm very happy to be in education. Thank you.
Great, sir. That is quite a unique approach and a different way of looking at things. Thank you so much for your response. Moving on, my next question would be that what is your philosophy on leadership and how would you like to describe your leadership style?
So my philosophy about educational leadership is, it is a journey. And you can say it is also a continuous process of channelizing the energy of teachers, students, staff to achieve the institution's goals. Leadership in education involves many factors such as domain expertise, with a vision and a plan. So if you have a domain expertise in the field of education, but you don't have a plan, then it will not work. And hence the, combination of expertise of the domain, vision and a plan is required. Same way, you have to empower your teachers and cultivate the leadership skills amongst themselves. Then inclusive and collaborative learning environment. So, we are talking about interdisciplinarity, we are offering the electives, but if we do not design our curriculum in such a way that real collaboration happens, then it will not work. And hence you will have to provide the environment such that, you have to join the hands with the industry, you have to join hands with the NGOs, you will have to send your students into the community to do certain services where you can say that inclusive and collaborative approach will actually materialize. Then you have to, as a leader, you will have to, utilize the data and optimization of resources is absolutely needed to achieve your goals. Then perseverance. So you will have to, after your ideas, your innovations and whatever job and activities to be done to achieve, the common goals, you may have to pursue continuously. And one of my favorite that, create an environment which has openness, transparency, And you should encourage people, stakeholders, students to think, question, and engage in the university. Thank you.
Right, sir. So in that case, how do you strategize about the key programs and plans for the marketing and administration of the university?
This is a very nice question, but I would like to answer it in one statement that we have only one strategy for all our programs, that is quality teaching, which leads to word of mouth, because there is no alternative of, you know, quality teaching. This is what I can say. And I can confidently say that Navarachna University is quite successful in achieving this. We are proud of our faculty and students. Our alumni are making an impact in the society as entrepreneurs, thought leaders, and successful managers in their respective fields.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, as we all know, the education institutes and programs in India and foreign countries are structured very differently. So, in your personal experience, what could be an inbound gain to the students studying here at Navarachna University?
I would slightly differ with this question in current scenario. If you talk a decade back, then I agree that, you know, there was a huge gap between Indian and a foreign education system. However, this gap has been narrowed down now since many years, because there are many reputed universities now in India like us who have introduced the concept of choice-based learning. And if you see the current national education policy, which also emphasizes on it. So we give flexibility to our students to learn the way they want. Whatever courses they want to pick, they can take. And, you know, academic freedom to the teachers in terms of, you know, changing the curriculum. If you just take an example of public university where curriculum is not getting changed for many years, and the industry is nowadays dynamic. So our faculties and students, you know, are doing what is currently demanded in the industry. We also have an innovative pedagogy such as experiential learning. They do the capstone project. They do the community services in, you know, collaboration with NGOs. And whatever I say, Navarachna University has incorporated all the above best practices in its curriculum for all its programs.
That's lovely. So I guess the demand as of date is more of practical learning and not less, but equally into theoretical learning as well. And
absolutely. So nowadays experiential learning is the key to, you know, success.
So moving on, could you give us some insights on how the university could be more welcoming to the students from different races or maybe economic backgrounds?
Certainly. So before answering your question, I would like to give you a brief about, you know, Navarachna University, how it has been formed. So Navarachna University is 10 years old, and we say that we are a young university. However, it is sponsored by Navarachna Education Society. You know, the society is acclaimed for its varied achievements, having imparted through its institutions quality education for almost five decades, predominantly to the children or the citizens of Vadodara, right, Gujarat. Srimati Tejalben Amin is the chairperson of the Navarachna Education Society, Navarachna University, and all the associated Navarachna schools. We believe in secularism, equality, and inclusivity. So we have students who are local to the city and region, across the state and country. We give a means-blind scholarship to the meritorious students. In exceptional cases, we offer full scholarship to such students. I have already, you know, given you a story on FB page of our chairperson. You may please, you know, post it onto your website such that people can understand that, you know, what compassion and empathy that we have towards all class of, you know, students across the country.
Sure. So I'm pretty sure of that. So moving on. What would you like people to know about Navarachna University that they might not know?
Of course, we have listed all our best practices on our website. However, let me discuss, you know, the Khoj project. So Navarachna University has introduced a unique teaching learning pedagogy, which we call as a cold, which we call it as a Khoj project. It gives an opportunity to all the students to learn the interdisciplinary courses across the university, which actually leads to a community-based project, and hence there is an impact in the society.
Right. So on that note, what do you see as Navarachna University's greatest strengths?
So if I list, there are many, but if I list, you know, five strengths, then I would like to say that we have an inclusive environment. We have an academic rigor with quality teaching, unique learning experience for our students. We have a passionate faculty and staff members who are willing to extend all the supports to our students. And we also offer means-blind scholarship for meritorious students.
Right. That was a great response, sir. Thank you so much. Moving on, my next question would be that what are some of the plans since you've been the newly appointed registrar at Navarasna University? How do you plan to invent, or what plans will you be designing for Navarasna University's international affairs and or students?
So we have executed MOUs recently with world-class universities such as Arizona State University, Binghamton University, North Dakota State University, USA, for faculty and student exchange programs. I'm sure that all these ventures will strengthen our international affairs over the period of time. Recently, we had a very good webinar series with the Binghamton University. You may go and check onto our website for those interesting videos.
Sure. Those are quite some partnerships, sir. All the very best to Navarasna University for future endeavors.
Thank you.
And thank you. Moving on to the last part of the interview, I would just like to understand that how do you tend to establish a healthy environment in your university?
So the mantra of this is, you know, we treat all our stakeholders as our family members, first of all. And we have a culture of openness, transparency, equality. We prepare our stakeholders, students, faculty, staff to be resilient, and we have a compassion and empathy, which will actually, you know, give you the healthy relationship with all your stakeholders. And we have a very positive environment in our university.
Definitely. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. That was quite an intellectual session, and it was great having you on our platform. Anyway, that was Dr. Sandeep Vasan, the registrar at Navarasna University. Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you, Ham. Thank you very much.